And hello, we are back with chapter 4. We last left off where Max had fucked things up epically. So it'll be very interesting to play the game in this new reality. Let's find out how that goes. Hold on, I gotta check the time. Okay, not even close. That's the one I gotta go pick up later. Let's resume! You know that insect on my screen almost looks real, like I could reach... That's not an insect. It's a crab? I don't know. Yes, Squeenix, show us your tile. Don't nod. I wonder where some of these companies get the inspiration for their names. That's nice, but I'm not playing Grim Eclipse right now, Steam. Speaking of Grim Eclipse, I've been hearing about some alt mods for outfits for the characters. I hope that's not just a rumor. I should make some Grim Eclipse playthroughs for y'all. I think I probably will after this.
It's weird hanging out with you again.
I know. I'm glad we are, though.
It was nice that you sent me actual letters. It's more than any of my other friends have done. And you even wrote on that cool parchment.
Chloe got the short end of the stick in this world.
So pretentious. But I love writing on it like an English poet. You deserve the best stationery.
Probably easier to write than to visit me. I don't mean that in a bitchy way. Not totally. You probably wanted to avoid awkward conversations like this.
Pretty much, yeah.
Look, the worst thing you can do is treat me like a baby. I still want to laugh and talk shit with my best friend. Can we stop? This is seriously the best view of the sunset. What do photographers call that?
The golden hour.
See? Without you here, I'd have no clue. Bet you could take some amazing shots. Those beach whales are so sad. I kind of know how they feel. At least, I'm alive here with you.
You're a real survivor, Chloe. I know you have to deal with so much.
I don't want anybody else feeling sorry for me. I can do that. Along with my parents. My dad still feels guilty about buying me that car.
Are you okay to talk about the accident?
We never actually have, huh? There's not much to say. Some prick in an SUV cut me off and I flew into a ditch.
Do you remember everything?
I saw everything in bullet time. I felt my back snap and...
Sheesh.
And that was the last thing I ever felt in my body. When I woke up in the hospital, I literally couldn't move a muscle.
Jesus. I don't know what to say.
Don't say anything. I'm just happy I did get to see you again. I could have ended up vanishing out of the blue like that girl from Blackwell.
You mean Rachel Amber? When was the last time you talked to her?
Never. I just read about her in the news. I didn't even know her name. You did?
She never even became friends with Rachel in this timeline. Chloe was all alone.
Like the end of the world.
It might be, but I'd like to think we can still change things for the better.
I'd like to think that too, but I don't have much hope these days.
I know things seem out of control, but as long as we're together, I don't feel afraid.
Hanging out with you makes me feel like a total kid again. You don't even know.
Listen, Chloe, I'm sorry I haven't been out to see you more. That was wrong. You're my best friend.
Max, thanks for coming out to see me. You're doing awesome.
I don't think so.
My nose is getting cold. Maybe we should get back to my place?
It is hella cold out here.
Hella? I hate that word, no offense.
None taken.
Wow, she really is very different. She looks so different without her blue hair. It's funny how color schemes on people and characters can totally just change the whole way that they look. I love my new hair color. I'm not getting rid of it for a long time. Mine would be blue if I could get away with it. Maybe one day I'll be able to. Put that in my last will and testament. Dye my hair blue for my funeral, because no one's going to care after I'm dead. Won't have to worry about finding jobs or what people think then. Even her house is blue. I keep noticing that. The theme with the blue butterfly, the blue hair, the blue house.
But I am lucky my parents bust their ass to take care of me. I know it's hard for them.
They're grateful you're here with them.
Right. Especially when they can't even take a walk alone. Sometimes I act like a total teenage brat just to give them an excuse to yell at me. Pathetic, I know.
Chloe, you're a great daughter. You're kind and sensitive. When you don't even have to be.
Trust me, I still get my rage on. Especially when a nurse has to watch while I take a dump so she can wipe my bum. Or when doctors flip me around like I was a science doll.
I can't even imagine. But you're still amazing. You always have been since we were kids.
Thanks again for coming, Max. I need to get my drink on. Can you bring me some water?
I guess she can't really drink beer with all the medicine she's probably on.
There's the old Chloe.
Whoa, Chloe can totally control her computer. It's so great people get this high-tech help. Chloe is still a punk at heart. But that's so cool that Chloe has made friends online. I should offer to put makeup on for Chloe. Not that I can, but it would be fun.
I don't think I could put makeup on someone else either.
Man, Joyce and William built a whole new bathroom for Chloe. They're so great. It's nice my parents sent a card at least.
Ryan and Vanessa Caulfield. We don't see a whole lot from her parents.
I still can't believe I put Chloe in that chair.
Yeah, we kind of fucked up big.
Max, it is so cool that you're here again.
I'm glad you think so.
Snow globes are taking over.
Oh, the snow dough. I guess not everything changed.
Hello, Chloe. She likes fluffy animals now.
Does Chloe look at the garden and think about her childhood? She can't even feel the grass now.
Okay, this is very... This is just all depressing. Let me get her her water.
Drink up, Buttercup. Oh, man. No wonder my throat is dry. I don't think I've talked this much the whole year.
Have you ever thought about doing a podcast or something?
I wish I could punch your face right now. A podcast? Dude, I am a pod in a cast. Boring. Ouch.
It was just a thought.
I know you're just trying to help.
Yeah, that's become a bad habit of mine.
You sound like an adult now. It seems like we were kids in another life.
Going through shit like this will age you.
What do you remember about us as kids? We all have different memories.
I think about us as little pirates running and jumping through Arcadia Bay.
Me too. But we're still pirates in our own way.
Yeah, right. Check me out, Chloe of the Caribbean. No way will I get on a fucking boat now. Unless you're with me.
I can't keep all my Excuse me. Which friends?
Which friends did you hang out with the most?
Megan Weaver, but you don't know her. She was cool. But after my accident, she was too cool for school.
I know I wasn't around much. No excuses, I'm a loser. But I am trying to make things right.
How? Dude, you're not Supermax. And I'm not trying to guilt trip you. That's what my parents are for.
Are they okay? I mean, are they still happy together and everything?
So now you're Dr. Bill? I guess they're good, considering they have to deal with me.
Dr. Bill?
They laugh and hold hands. And I hope they still get busy, too.
I think Joyce and William are incredible.
Max, the accident has been so hard on them. Our insurance sucks, and the medical bills are fucking insane.
I bet. This tech must be crazy expensive.
Along with the drugs, the nurses, the supplies. Mom and Dad are always broke, and they get so frustrated. Is it worth it?
Chloe, you're priceless. No pun intended.
You are such a geek. That's why I love you. Of course, I know a geek when I be one. See, I'm practically a human entertainment system. It would be sweet to chill out together and watch a movie like when you'd spend the night at my house.
What do you want to watch?
I think I'm in like a mellow Blade Runner mood. I always cry at the end. Plus, you know, I always wanted to have cool colored bangs like Pris.
I know. You would look incredible with blue hair.
We would know.
Let's get this show on the road. And you better not fall asleep on me like you always do when we watch movies.
I remember, Max. Swear I won't fall asleep. Not when you're here. Not yet.
Not yet. I'm not sure I like the way that sounded.
Thanks. I think you missed a grain stuck in my eyeball.
Hard to believe how just a little sand can cause such a big mess.
It's like that Chinese proverb, a spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie. You know, like the butterfly thing.
Yeah, this whole game has basically been the butterfly effect.
She has to use a lot of lotion to keep her blood circulating.
You're really my only friend who kept in touch.
I should have kept more in touch.
I didn't know lotion did that, to be honest.
Medical supplies. Here's the DVD.
Man, her room compared to the room that she had. So depressing. I like that little subtle shot they had there where she's watching Max more than she's watching the movie. It really is isolating to be sick like that. I was very sick for about over a year. Not bedridden or anything, but it really does make you feel like crap. And then when you can't get out to do anything, and don't feel like getting out to do anything, it really doesn't help your social life much.
I cannot believe you fell asleep so fast. How dare you?
I know you were beat down after the day with me, and Blade Runner is a pretty dreamy movie to watch at night. Do you think Deckard is a replicant? Sorry, I can see you're not wide awake like me.
No, I'm sorry I crashed so hard. Were you okay?
I do have a mother and father when you're not falling asleep on me.
You are a bitch in the morning.
It's the company I keep.
I don't think I would ever have been able to fall asleep in a chair like that.
Yesterday was such a blast. It was great. Seeing you.
I know things were different when we were just dorky kids, but being with you made me feel like when we were little pirates, jumping and running through the forests again. It meant a lot to me just to chill out with you and bullshit. Fuck. I'm getting my regular head pains. Can you pretty please go upstairs and get my morphine injector in the bathroom?
Morphine injector?
It's total Star Trek shit. You can't even see the needle. Seriously, I need it. My parents keep the swag upstairs because they think I can't get to it. But you can, Max. Like a pirate, right?
I'm on it, Chloe.
Alright, let's go get her medicine. Hello, William.
Insurance is worthless.
At least you're still alive.
Oh, sure. That's great they finally went to Paris.
Looking at the tower? Really? I still can't believe I'm friends with them. I can't even process Victoria being my friend. Oh, we got different texts in this world. Her and her stupid plant, she's stuck on that. Don't forget to water your plant. I wish I could just figure out. Him being nice is even weirder. Interesting note from Alyssa.
This is just for Chloe's basic supplies.
Jeez. These bills should all just say, "Dear sir, you are screwed."
William.
They gave Chloe their giant expensive HDTV, and they use our shitty tube television. To think that our destiny is linked to goddamn car keys.
I know, right? Can you go outside? No, you can't.
I'm not gonna say fucking.
No snow globes. They're all in Chloe's room.
These whales are just a preview of the tornado to come. Rachel Amber is even missing in this reality. I guess I can't change everything.
Nope.
They might get their own home taken away because of medical bills. That's terrible.
Jeez.
Hey, William. Am I bothering you?
Why, yes, Max. I love going through bills. Kidding. How can you bother me? I haven't seen you in forever.
I know. You look exactly the same. It's so cool.
Good. Or I'd be scared if I didn't look like me. Of course, you seem more adult now. So what's on your mind?
You guys went to Paris.
Oui, as they say. Not me, because I can't speak French. But it was a great experience, especially for Chloe.
I can see her loving it there. You guys rock for going on a family adventure like that.
She talked about going to school there, but that's not practical anymore.
I guess not.
It's not fair, Max.
I don't know how to say this, but I'm truly sorry about what happened to Chloe.
Yeah, it was kind of my fault.
All it takes is a few minutes to change a girl's whole life. But she's alive. She's been a trooper.
She is amazing. I'm so glad you're here to help her. And be her father.
I'm so glad Joyce is here to help us both. Max, I just hate to think of what would happen to Chloe if I wasn't here.
William? I just want you to know that whatever happens, I'll always be here for Chloe. Always.
I know you will, Max.
I was impressed by Chloe's room and all the high-tech equipment.
You should be. We could buy a few mansions for what it all costs. The insurance helps, but...
Doesn't look like it's helping enough.
I know it must be hard on you guys, financially.
These bills are more like crushing. We have to mortgage our home, and that's pretty scary. But we'll get through it. The price is always right. Get it? No?
Being around you and Joyce again is so nostalgic.
Very old school, as they say. I think it's great for Chloe to see you. Makes Joyce happy, too. So it's not all bad news in Arcadia Bay. Or is it?
The Prescott family might be bad news. What do you think about them?
Evil. Next question.
I really like William.
More than I want to. But Joyce has to work for those greedy bastards at Pan Estates. I don't even like to think about it.
I was reading about that missing girl. Rachel Amber.
Oh, yes, she went to Blackwell, right? Oh, poor thing. That's a real nightmare for a family. I get scared thinking about Chloe and that we might lose her someday.
I don't want to talk about the weather.
I have to go see if Chloe needs anything.
Yeah, girl's kind of waiting on her
morphine. It's so great talking with you again.
You act like it's the last time. And please, keep me from these bills whenever you want.
No change to spare anymore. Now it's back to cookies.
I want a cookie.
Joyce is a food coupon boss.
Same answering machine. Hasn't changed much.
Joyce and William never had a garage sale before. They're drowning in debt.
just to take care of their daughter. Such bullshit. It
really is. Stupid expensive just to take care of somebody. It's ridiculous. Oh wait, I do need to turn the light on, I think. Yes. Now we can see what we're doing.
The bathroom looks almost the same. Just more medicine.
Well, it would.
Here it is. I never thought I'd be delivering morphine to my best friend. Nothing here.
Okay, this is just a search for the medicine.
How's it going, Time Tripper? Funny. I think I look older.
Well, seeing this shit probably aged you.
It's all about you, Arcadia Bay, isn't it?
I wonder if Joyce is here. There's Joyce.
Oh, Max, it is so nice to have you.
Look at them. They have no... That is such a sweet shot of Chloe. I wonder who took the picture.
I love how in these games you can just
so hard.
Snoop He's through awesome. Everything. And nobody even stops you.
Oh no. I didn't realize how bad Chloe's injury really was.
So, Chloe's basically dying. Great. This just gets more and more depressing.
Joyce is already a super mom.
It's good for Chloe.
Joyce used to hate smokers in the diner.
The amount of stress she's under.
Good morning, Max. Oh, you and Chloe are so much quieter now than when you were kids.
Most people do get that way.
It's nice waking up in your house again.
Oh, William and I love it. Finally seeing you and Chloe together after all these years. After the accident.
I have to tell you how much I love seeing you and William together again.
He's been such a hero through all this. Chloe and I, lucky to have him.
Chloe and William seem like they still get along so good.
Yeah, those two are closer now more than ever. Chloe will actually listen to William while she usually ignores me. Oh, it's so cute when they gang up on poor old me.
You rule, Joyce.
Shit, things would be different if I did. I like how you think, kid.
I wish I was a better friend. I know Chloe doesn't get many visitors.
Oh, Max, you're Chloe's best friend for a reason. You're here exactly when she needs you.
Who helps Chloe out when you guys are at work?
We have a series of revolving nurses and caretakers. Chloe still causes trouble, even if she can't move. Max, Chloe's condition is not improving. Her respiratory system is very weak, and do you know what I'm saying?
God, Joyce. This is depressing.
I'm so sorry you have to go through all this.
Bad or good, I embrace every moment with my daughter and my husband. This is what it means to be a family. And we'll always be one. No matter what.
You do rule, Joyce.
How are you doing, Joyce?
I'm doing the best I can, Max. I won't lie. It's difficult, but... nobody said life was easy here in Arcadia Bay.
This is depressing.
I better get back to Chloe now.
I'm gonna go give Chloe her morphine.
You too, honey. I know. Things aren't as neat and tidy as they used to be.
Down the stairs we go.
Finally. Give me the blue pill. I'm sorry. I'm nosy, but not precise. Go ahead and plug it right in. It's so easy. And painless. Okay, but get ready to yell for your folks if I screw up. Oh, trust me. I will. Of course, my pain just keeps getting worse. But you caught me on a good day. Max, I'm so grateful that I'm even able to hang out with you. See, I'm getting mushy. I'm already high. You're so adorable. Do you want anything else? Stop me if I'm being too emo, but can you grab one of the photo albums over there? I'd like to check out some old pictures of us when we were kids. Please, my diary is like emo ground zero. Plus, Max Caulfield does not pass up a photo op with Chloe Price. Ever.
Speaking of my journal, it should have changed. Oh. God, yes, it changed. Man, Max, you became like a totally different person. You actually like the Vortex Club?
Despite everything, they're still a happy family again. It's cool that in this reality, Chloe really loves skating too. Chloe was a straight-A student. She could have gone to any college. What a bastard. I totally should have let Chloe steal your bullshit fund, even if it wasn't another reality.
I think I did, if I remember correctly, let Stowe. Oh, wait.
Is that okay? Perfect. Oh my god. Look how little we are there. We look like toys. I remember that day by the lighthouse. My dad was pissed at us. He actually tried to give us a timeout. And you laughed at him. My dad would have banished me. Whoa, awesome picture. We look so badass in our pirate gear. We should have taken over Arcadia Bay when we had the chance. There's still time for you. Oh man, there we are making pancakes. I love that shot of us. It's hard to believe my dad took that picture only 5 years ago. Literally seems like yesterday. I wish it was. Me too. This photo. Maybe I could.
Yeah, that's the photo that changed everything.
Listen, Max. My respiratory system is failing, and
it's only getting worse. I've heard the doctors talking about it when they thought I was zonked out. So, I know I'm just putting off the inevitable while my parents suffer along, and I will too. This isn't how I want things to end.
What? What are you saying?
I'm saying that being with you again has been so special. I just wanted to feel like when we were kids running around Arcadia Bay and everything was possible, and you made me feel that way today. I want this time with you to be my last memory.
Oh,
do you understand?
Yeah, yes, I think I do.
I do.
All you have to do is crank up the IV to 11.
Oh my god, I tried to fix her life, and now she doesn't even live. And the bad thing is that I understand this. I understand in this situation, you're not really living. You're existing, surviving, I suppose, but there's no quality of life left. There's nothing to look forward to every day. And I can understand why in this situation somebody would want to. But God, this game doesn't pull any punches with the decisions.
Chloe,
are you sure?
I really don't know if I could do this. I had another friend who wanted to end it all, and I did everything I could to try and save her life. How can I be responsible for ending yours? I mean, there's gotta be another way. Max, you were there for your friend, no matter what. Now I'm asking you to help me the same way. I want to help you, Chloe, but I think my help is hurting. At least you have a choice. When you want to make a decision, you can just do it. Look at me. I'm at the mercy of everybody. For once, I want to make my own choice. The most important one of my life. Please. Help me, Max.
God, this is awful. This is absolutely awful. And I don't think that I could do this in real life. I hope I never have to do something like this in real life. But seeing as how it's a game, and I can rewind anyway, and seeing as it's my freaking fault, or at least Max's freaking fault.
Chloe, I'll just drift to sleep, dreaming of us here together, forever. Thank you so much. I'm so proud of you for following your dreams. Don't forget about me.
Never.
I love you, Max. See you around.
Sooner than you think.
The only thing I could do was put her out of her misery. Okay.
I'm sorry, William.
Oh, no. But that's literally the only way to fix this. is to put it all back.
Someday Dad'll get one of them newfangled computers.
I hope the flash didn't scare you, Max. This is a keeper. Hello? Hey, honey. What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course I'll come pick you up. Shit, where are my keys?
That's a dollar for the swear jar.
You mean your college fund. Aha! You can't hide from me forever. And no Chloe and Max wine tasting session.
Dad!
Don't blow it, because tonight your mother promised to make us a world-famous salmon surprise with chocolate cake for dessert. Max, you'll be here too, right?
She's never leaving me.
That makes all of us.
Oh, man.
Max, you are being so fucking strange. Like, you're never gonna see us again.
Chloe, I'm so sorry. I tried to make things different for you. I did try. I'm sorry.
I don't know exactly what you're talking about, but come on. You have made things different, like, my whole life. You're my best friend. I've got you and a great family. What's to be sorry for? We'll be best friends forever. And when we grow up, we're taking over the world.
Listen, whatever happens, I want you to be strong. Even if you feel like I wasn't there for you. Because I will never abandon you, Chloe. I'll always have your back. Always.
Max, you get one kiss and now you're all over me?
I'm so glad you're here.
You sound high, but thanks for the morning grub.
Okay, I think I've been playing a good 30 minutes, and these videos get really hard to render the longer that they get, and they really kill my CPU and take forever to upload, so I think right here would probably be a good part to break off on this chapter. And I'll resume part 2 somewhere around this area. God, this game is testing my mental fortitude here. But anyway, thanks for watching. Like and subscribe if you enjoyed, and I will return.